Today I'm going to be reviewing the brand Curla. And full disclosure, all of these products were sent to me by PR, which means that Curl Up sent me all of their products to try out and test out for you guys. However, this review is going to be completely unbiased and I'm going to give you all of my honest thoughts and opinions on the products. Now, I'm not even going to lie, this is going to be a really long video because my reviews are quite extensive, they're quite detailed. I make sure to explain things to you like 100% so that you know exactly what to expect before you make a purchase. And so in that sense, I really can't help the length of this video. All I can say is grab a snack and keep watching. Alright, so first off, we're going to be talking about the Curl Up Oil. This comes in a 100 ml bottle. When it comes to pre-pooing with this oil, it doesn't suit my scalp. My scalp is quite sensitive to this oil. When I use this oil to pre-poo, I've noticed that it causes some sensitivity in my scalp, and that leads me to believe that maybe I'm allergic to one of the ingredients in the oil and therefore I'm not able to use it on my scalp because I've noticed that my scalp gets pretty inflamed and irritated when I use it. However, what I can use this oil for is to SOTC. Whenever I scrunch out the crunch, I really enjoy using this oil because it has this peppermint and rosemary smell. It's a very, very pretty smell. I really enjoy using this as a serum. Barring the Earth Rhythm serum, I would say that this is heavier than the other serums that I have. So when I'm SOTCing and I'm using an oil, then this is something that I enjoy using. Now, on days when I worked out, you guys know that I don't do too many refreshes on my hair. I like my hair to be as it is during the week, and on those days when I'm concerned that, hey, is my hair smelling rank, then this oil is really nice to use as a serum. So on days when I'm looking for a slight refresh in the form of a serum and I'm concerned about my hair not smelling the best, then this is something that I use because that combination of rosemary and peppermint, it's really nice, it's really fragrant, and it doesn't trigger my migraines. It's a really pretty minty smell. So this is something that I prefer on those days. You also heard me mention that I like to SOTC with this. Why? Because on days when I'm using, let's say, a gel that has alcohol and I'm concerned that, hey, my hair is really dried out and I'm looking to infuse that moisture back into my hair, then this is something that I'll use. This tends to do a really nice job and it really adds that nice shine and moisturization, especially on days when my hair is feeling really dry. It comes in a unicarton and this is what the oil looks like. It has a spray dispenser, but it doesn't come out as a spray. It comes out as a heavy oil. You've seen me using this when I scrunch out the crunch in my last video on the Denman brush. I'll leave that video linked down below. So next, let's talk about the shampoo. This comes in a 200 ml bottle and it has a pump dispenser. This is a very cleansing shampoo. I feel like if you have a normal to oily scalp, this shampoo is going to suit you. It is quite thick and it's quite viscous. Another thing that I really like about the shampoo is that a little bit goes a long way. It is really foaming and lathering. So if you're looking for a cleansing shampoo and you enjoy your shampoos lathering quite a bit, then this is something that you might enjoy. However, if you suffer from migraines that are triggered by fragrances, then I feel like this shampoo will not be for you because the fragrance is quite overpowering and it does tend to trigger my migraines. Next, I want to talk about the Curl Hydration Conditioner. This comes in a 200 ml tube. Now, this conditioner is really, really, really nice. It is thick, it is creamy, it has incredible slip. It is also very moisturizing. So if you're looking for great slip and great moisturization, then I feel like you might really enjoy this conditioner. It has immaculate slip. It is so thick. It is so creamy. Detangling your hair will be a dream in that sense. I love this conditioner. However, if you suffer from migraines that are triggered by fragrances, then I would not recommend this conditioner to you. Next, I want to talk about the hair mask. This is their Intense Hydrating Hair Mask. And this is exactly as the name suggests. It is intensely hydrating. It has immaculate slip. If you thought the conditioner has great slip, wait till you try this product. It is so heavy. It is so creamy. It is so thick. If you're the kind of person who can do away with a conditioner And you can go in with a hair mask and start detangling, squish to condition, then do your twist up and then deep condition. If you're like a one and done kind of person, then you will really, really, really enjoy detangling your hair with this mask. And if you're the kind of person who enjoys intense moisturization and you need a mask that is really nice and heavy and nice and moisturizing, then you will love this mask. Out of all of the products that I'm talking about today, this is my absolute favorite. I really, really enjoy it. I have high porosity hair. My hair is 2B, 2C and 3A. It was heavy enough for my hair and I cannot tell you how impressed I am by this mask. Highly recommend to high porosity girls. This does not have a fragrance that is irritating. Now it's important to note that when the brand came up, they started with their shampoo and their conditioner and their leave-in conditioner. And those products are more on the fragrance side and would trigger migraines if you have a sensitivity towards fragrance. However, the gel and the mask and the oil came later. And so I feel like the brand has learnt and has done a better job. All of the products that came out later do not have this fragrance issue. Now, before I start talking about the leave-in conditioner, I want to talk about the gel because, as you know in my reviews, I focus a lot on leave-in conditioners because, in my opinion, I feel like that is like the make or break product when it comes to your wash day results. So, about this gel, this is a medium hold gel. It comes in a 200 ml bottle. It's a really nice gel. It gives you a fantastic cast if you use enough. You can opt for damp styling or wet styling. I feel like if you use enough, the cast is going to be really nice. It is going to hold your curls. I have a detailed review where I compare this to the Enliven gel. And so I'm going to leave that down in the description. You can hear my detailed thoughts on the gel. But to just sum up that video, really nice gel, really nice and moisturizing. You can use this as a one and done product when you're refreshing and you don't want to use a leave-in conditioner because the product has film-forming humectants that do a really good job if you're trying to use them as a one and done product. The downside of this gel is it does not give me too much volume and does not give me too much shrinkage. If you're interested in knowing more about the gel, I would highly recommend you check out this video and you will get a good idea of all of my detailed thoughts on the gel. But to just sum things up, out of all of the CG friendly gels that I have used thus far, this one is my favorite. Alright, so next we're talking about the leave-in conditioner. This is the Curl Up Curl Defining Cream. This comes in a 150 gram tube. In my opinion, the Curl Defining Cream is a solid level 3 product. If you're looking for some beautiful moisturization and prefer leave-in conditioners that are on the heavier side, then I feel like you're really going to enjoy this leave-in conditioner. When I use this leave-in conditioner, I notice that 8 grams of product is absolutely sufficient for my hair. And as you can see, I have really, really long hair. So 8 grams of the cream works perfectly fine for me. I'm going to put up exactly how long I feel like the product is going to last on the screen right here. So now let me get into some of the things that I absolutely loved about this product. Number one, it is super thick and super moisturizing. And so if you're looking for intense moisturization, then I feel like you are going to love this leave-in conditioner. Next, let's talk about definition and shrinkage. I feel like the product does a fairly decent job at the shrinkage and the definition that it gives me. However, I feel like the shrinkage could be a little better because there are other products that give me way more shrinkage as compared to this one. And so when it comes to definition and shrinkage, I would say that it does a fairly decent job. Definitely not the best I've tried, but definitely not the worst that I've tried by a long shot. The next thing that I absolutely loved about the product is that a little bit goes a long way. So when I style my hair, I generally use 4 sections. I've noticed that I need lesser than a dime size amount on each section and it is perfectly sufficient to give my hair that moisturization. And so I definitely feel like this product is a bang for your buck because it's going to last you a really long time. Next, we're talking about moisture retention for high porosity hair. As we know, high porosity hair needs more and really struggles with moisture retention during the week. And as we know, I have high porosity hair. So during the week, I had absolutely no problem retaining moisture in my hair. It is absolutely sufficient. So high porosity girls, if you're looking for a leave-in conditioner that is more cream-based and gives you some beautiful moisturization and you need your leave-in conditioner to be on the heavier side, I feel like you're really gonna enjoy this product. All right, so those were all of the things that I absolutely loved about the product. Now let's talk about some of the things that I did not like about the product. Number one is that it pills and it bunches. So when you're emulsifying this, make sure to use enough water, because if you don't use enough water, then you will notice that it is going to pill and bunch on your hands. And when you're done using this and you go onto your gel, make sure to wipe your hands down, because once the gel and the leave-in conditioner get together, it gets a little pilly and a little bunchy. I hope I'm making sense. Another tip that I can give you is, once you're done applying using praying hands, take a little more water, spray your hands down and emulsify. Once again, you'll notice that you'll have a little more cream on your hand. So don't waste that product. All right, so the next thing that I did not like about the product. So this product took a lot of trial and error. It took a lot of experimentation. The first few times I used it, I felt like my hair was super moisturized, more on the over moisturized side. And I wasn't exactly sure of whether I liked it or not. It took a lot of experimenting. And so I definitely feel like there is a learning curve when you're using this cream, because it is heavy. If you use too much, then it can absolutely weigh your hair down and stretch out your hair and not give you nice shrinkage. So the next thing that I did not like about the product is that it has a tendency to weigh your hair down, especially if you're not using enough. I'll tell you what happened when I used the product. I felt like there was a learning curve to it. I really struggled to find exactly the right amount for my hair, because the first few times I used it, I felt like my hair was becoming over moisturized and really heavy. It was weighing my hair down quite a bit. And so I started using progressively less. Once I hit on that 8-gram mark, and now whenever I use the product, I always make sure to weigh it out before I'm using it, because it is quite possible for you to go overboard. Even if you use a little extra, then it is possible for your hair to feel super weighed down. And so what I'm trying to say is, this product definitely has a learning curve. I did struggle with it quite a bit when I started, but once I found the right amount for my hair, it has been smooth sailing since. All right, so the last thing, and I feel like this is like the most important critique that I can give to the brand about this product. Now, the fragrance of this is far too overwhelming. It is very, very heavy, and people who have migraines will really, really struggle to use this leave-in conditioner. I want to add another point to this. So if you started CG and you started off using a normal conditioner as leave-in conditioner, and you noticed that that kind of moisturization was perfect for you, and now that you have a little more money, now that you've spent a few more months on your CG journey, you're looking for a leave-in conditioner, then this leave-in conditioner would be my recommendation to you, because this is a solid level 3. It is exactly the same kind of moisturization that you have been getting from your normal conditioner. And so in that sense, I feel like this leave-in conditioner is going to suit a plethora of hair types. A lot of people are really, really going to enjoy this leave-in conditioner. And for a lot of people who are just starting CG, more often than not, I feel like if this is the first leave-in conditioner that they pick up, then their quest ends right there. It doesn't get any better than this when it comes to moisturization. However, a lot of people are going to struggle to use this leave-in conditioner because of the overpowering fragrance. So this fragrance, I don't feel like reducing the fragrance will do much, because I feel like the nature of the fragrance is such that just one whiff of it and it is sufficient to give you a full-blown migraine. As you guys know, I suffer from horrendous migraines. And in order for me to use this product, I literally have to take it, I have to put it in a bowl, I have to set it aside for hours for the fragrance to dissipate, and that is when I'm somewhat able to use this fragrance. So what I've noticed is, certain months are worse than others. I feel like my migraines are far worse. So in January and February, my migraines tend to be at like an all-time high. During these months, I'm not going to be able to use this leave-in conditioner. You guys saw me unbox this last January. And since then, I have been holding on to the product and waiting for my migraines to sort of die down. And through hard struggle, I was able to start using this product, I think, in June, July, not before that. Sorry, I went off on a bit of a tangent there, but coming back to the point, I feel like this product is gonna suit a lot of hair types and I really want to recommend it to everybody. However, the fragrance is just not cutting it. I don't think reducing the fragrance is gonna change much because just a little bit of the fragrance, just a little whiff of the fragrance is enough to set me into the worst migraines of my life. So what I'm trying to say is, if you have migraines that are triggered by fragrances, then this leave-in conditioner is absolutely not for you and I would not recommend it to you. However, it is an absolute shame because I definitely see this leave-in conditioner working for so many different curl types. It's going to work for high porosity hair. It's going to work for medium porosity hair. It's going to work for tighter curl patterns. It's going to do such a good job. This could be such a beautiful, versatile product. However, because of the fragrance, I feel like a lot of people are not going to be able to use this leave-in conditioner. And so in my opinion, I feel like that is the biggest disadvantage of this product. All right, so next, let's talk about all of the ingredients of all of the products that I've mentioned here today. I'm gonna put up pop-ups right here. Alright, lastly, we come to my advice for the brand. This is something that I did with my last review and I quite enjoyed it. So yeah, nobody asked, but I'm gonna attempt to give the brand some of my advice. When it comes to the shampoo, the conditioner, and the leave-in conditioner, I feel like maybe you could reformulate and completely change the fragrance. Again, I don't feel like reducing the amount of fragrance of the products are gonna do much. I feel like the products require a revamp where the fragrance is changed altogether, so as to accommodate people who suffer from migraines, because there are a lot more of us than you think. Alright, so next I want to talk about the packaging of the products. Very pretty, very aesthetic packaging. What would I change? So the shampoo and the gel come in these bottles, right? Which I can easily recycle. And I can also give this to the kabariwala. In Bengali, we call them the bikiriwala. And I can easily recycle these bottles. However, when it comes to the leave-in conditioner and the conditioner, since this is a tube, when I'm on the verge of finishing these products, I'm probably going to be cutting these products to get to the last bits, the last dregs of the product, right? And so I'm not going to be able to recycle this. It seems like such a waste. It would be really nice if you guys reformulated and maybe gave us like a bottle so that it's easier to recycle these products once I'm done with them. So the last bit of advice that I want to give to the brand is the leave-in conditioner. A lot of people are going to enjoy this, but since this is 500 rupees plus, a lot of people are not going to be able to afford this. Now, since I mentioned that whenever I use around 8 grams of product, and that's perfectly sufficient. I feel like it would be so nice if the brand came out with like a smaller size. Maybe not as small as 50 grams because that doesn't really make sense. If you can come out with like 80 grams of the product and maybe keep the price at like 350, I'm so sorry, I know I'm being super presumptuous, but hey, listen, I'll shoot my shot, right? So, in order to make this a little more affordable for students and beginners to CG, my advice to the brand would be that it would be amazing if you gave us the leave-in conditioner in an 80 gram pack. That way, we can use the product for 2.5 months. You can keep the price lower than 500 and something rupees. That way, I'm able to recommend the product in budget videos. That way, people on a budget can afford this product. And that would be absolutely amazing. With that, we come to the end of this video. Feel free to give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment if you gain value. And if you're interested in hair care, feel free to check out these videos.